Hi everyone, I hope you're having a great Sunday. This video is for VEDA Day 29, and I decided to do the 20 Questions Loc Tag. I know it's an old tag, it's been around since 2011 as far as I know. That's the furthest back I've seen the video being done, but since I'm new to the Loc game and I wanted to have a video for Day 29 of VEDA, I figured I would do the 20 Questions Loc Tag. So I toyed with the idea of locking in March 2012 when I had did this these particular mini twists. And I remember posting these photos on Facebook, and I stated that I was thinking about locking and asked everyone's opinions. Now, a lot of people gave me positive response to the pictures, said that I would probably look good with locks, yada yada yada. But then a few days later, I chickened out and I said that I wouldn't lock because it required a level of commitment that I wasn't ready for. Then early in 2013, I started feeling all fed up with my loose natural hair. I got tired of the detangling process, the styling process, and that's when I did that video in February talking about wanting to cut my hair off. But, you know, I compromised with my husband. He was like, okay, maybe you can cut a few inches, but don't cut it all off because I don't want you to regret it. So I cut maybe 1 to 2 inches off my hair. I remember I had, I think, maybe 5 to 6 inches of hair all the way around. And I was wearing protective styles after that. So I remember doing crochet braids twice. And also, I put in a set of kinky twists as well. So by the time I took my locks out and my protective style and debuted my natural hair at the new job that I received in April of last year, I started again kind of feeling like I wanted to cut my hair off again. I just remember last June, I was watching a video that Cheska Locks did. It was, it was a video for Hair Love and Lock Appreciation Day. I think the Hair Love video was in response to Tracy Ellis Ross's video she had done about Hair Love, and she wanted people to respond to her. And I just remember being so fascinated with Cheska Locks' video, I'm sorry. I was so fascinated with her hair and her curls. Now, I haven't watched her for years, but for some reason, it's like I saw her hair and her locks in a new light. And so I started toying with the idea again of either locking my hair or shaving my head. So my husband was not down for the head shaving. So I did research online. I had a lock consultation in June of last year, and my locks were started in July 2011. So this picture I'm about to show you is pretty much the last time I wore my hair out. So my hair was about that long when I got my locks installed. Sorry, that was such a long answer. I'm trying to make this video go by a little bit faster. Well, my locks were started by a loctician with 2-strand twists. And I did a video showing you my hair, but I also have a photo of how my 2-strand twists looked on my loc install day. So this is where I started from. Okay. Well, they are 10 months old, and they're going to be 11 months old on May 11th. Well, not really sure. A lot of people pick the longest dread to be the one in the back, but I just feel like the one in the back right now, they're closer to like my shoulders, so I don't think it would be fair for me to pick that lock. But I do have a lock on the side to me that I feel like is freakishly long, and that's this one. I think it's this one. Yeah. Is it? So this lock to me, this is my longest lock. And it's at collarbone length. Whoops. And then I would have to say my shortest dread would be like these up here in the top in the front. As far as measuring them, I haven't measured them, at least not yet. Well, I think all of my locks are awesome and unique to me, as all dreads are not the same, if that makes sense. And I don't have any locks that I feel are strange, at least right now. So I counted my locks on more than one occasion, and most recently I came up with 87, and they are the same number that I had since I started, because I haven't done any combining or anything like that. So I just recently started using Eden Body Works Peppermint Tea Tree Shampoo and Conditioner. Previously I was using Tresemme Natural Shampoo and Conditioner. I guess they had reformulated it, so I was using the old formula. And every once in a while I would use my husband's Paul Mitchell Tea Tree Special Shampoo, because I just like getting that tingling feeling. So I decided recently to get my own Peppermint Tea Tree Shampoo so that I'd stop using up his. I also use the Cream of Nature Argan Oil Leave-In Spray. It's the one you have to shake up before you spray it on your hair. I use jojoba oil, Jamaican black castor oil, and I just recently started using the Fruit of the Earth brand aloe vera gel. Normally I wash them every 2 weeks, but sometimes I may wash it a little bit more, especially if my scalp is really itching or if my hair has been exposed to certain elements, like dust when we go camping, or if we're even hanging out like we did last night at our friend's house. They have like a fire pit in their backyard, so we were hanging out around the fire pit, so I got a lot of smoke and stuff exposed to me, or I was exposed to a lot of smoke and ashes. So I'll probably be washing my hair today because of that. All right, so this is gonna be a long answer. In the beginning, I was maintaining my hair myself. I was so excited. I was washing and retwisting like crazy. My first wash and retwist was at 3 weeks. The second one was at 5. The third was at 7. And then I started with every 4 weeks. I calmed that down because I just didn't want to retwist too often. In January, I was frustrated with my hair. I was going through getting ready to do a retwist, and I wanted to clean up my parts and had set up my mirrors, and I just was just over it. So that was when I contacted a loctician and a different salon from the salon that started my locks, and I was able to get a same day appointment, and they interlocked my hair. So January, February, and March, she interlocked my hair. But not only did she interlock, she kind of palm rolled. And what I mean is, when my hair was shampooed and conditioned and everything, of course, I have all this frizz. So she would do like a twist, and then she would feed my lock through doing her thing. And then she'll go through and take the loose hairs or the frizz, and she would just wrap it around like this. And then she would palm roll it. So that's what I mean by she interlocked and she palm rolled. I recently decided to go back to maintaining my hair myself. So on the 5th of April, that's when I shampooed and conditioned my hair, and I used Jamaican black castor oil only to do my no clip retwist. I'm not sure if I did a video about that, but I did post pictures on Instagram and on my Facebook like page. And I kind of got disappointed because a few days later I helped my daughter move to her apartment. So I kind of sweated out all around here. And that prompted my video of me talking about how I was on the fence again with palm rolling and interlocking. And I did a no-go, a big no-no. And on the 22nd, which was what, Tuesday, I actually did another shampoo and condition and no clip retwist using Jamaican black castor oil and aloe vera gel mixed together, which I thought was a very good combination, but it was way too soon. And since I'm going to be shampooing again today, because I was hanging out near the campfire, I'm just going to shampoo, condition, Sorry, y'all, I'm in my backyard. I'm gonna shampoo, condition, and I'm just gonna do some pipe cleaner curls and just leave it be. And also, my head started itching Wednesday when I took, well, Wednesday I wore my hair in a twist to work, but on Thursday, like Wednesday evening, my head just started itching. I think because I didn't really need to retwist like all of this, but I should just retwist it around my front edges and my back edges, because that's where most of the unraveling had been done. So yeah, I've learned my lesson. Right now I don't wear any beads or decorations. I would love to wear cowrie shells because I really like cowrie shells, but I'm just gonna wait until my locks are more mature for that. Love me for me and don't compare me to others, as I am unique to you. Well, I used to think that I would restart them smaller, especially when I got caught up in the comparison game, looking at other people's locks and thinking that my current locks should be smaller because my hair isn't as full as theirs. But when I think about it, 87 locks may not seem like a lot right now, but let's just say my hair gets down to here, then I might be happy I have 87 locks, because they may not be as heavy as me walking around with like 120, 130 locks. I think the only thing I would do differently if I were to do, like if I were just start over on locks, I would probably big chop for a fresh start and then get my locks started so that I can, it's been nice to watch my hair transform from where it was to where it is now, but I think it would be a real amazing transformation to maybe start with my hair about an inch long to see where my locks would be after about a year and stuff. So yeah, that's what I would do different. No, I just have regular piercings. I don't have any tattoos. I have two piercings in my ear. You probably can't see it, but the first piercing was done when I was a baby. The second piercing was done when I was 15. When I was in the military, I couldn't wear my earrings, and because the second piercing was probably so young, so to speak, they almost closed all the way up, so I had to get them re-pierced once I got out of the military. In my previous organization, I did know three people that had locks. It was one female and two males. I didn't, at that time, because I wasn't really into locking for myself, I never really asked them a lot about locks. But now I don't really know anyone that has locks. I do have a younger cousin that has locks, but I never was around him. He's 18, and I moved away from home the first time I joined the military, and that was when I was 20, you know. So I haven't really lived in my hometown since I was 20. I mean, I was home for like 4, maybe 5 months between December 1999 and May 2000. So I was home for 5 months, but you know, he's more of my daughter's age. So when my daughter would go back and visit, she hung out with him. So that's pretty much all I know. So I was already employed when I started my locks at my current company. I did interview and get my new position that I have now during my lock journey. I was not hired because of my locks. I was hired because of my presentation during the interview, as well as the quality of my processing work that they reviewed over the course of the time I had been at the company. I haven't gotten anything yet about my locks. Not yet. Well, I don't have any in my personal life because, like I said, I don't really know anybody that has dreads. There are some people that inspire me on, well, a lot of people that inspire me on YouTube, but nobody in my, you know, personal life. I'm not sure. There are a ton of dreaded YouTubers that I enjoy watching. They have great personalities. But because I'm very, very shy, I don't think I would know how to talk with any of them if we met personally. So I would just say I don't see myself hanging out with any of them. No offense. And that's because I'm just shy and awkward. So it probably may not be a good experience. But, you know, people like Kyo Kimmis and Jessica Lee and Bronze Goddess and Coco Femme and Jalicia, their personalities, they're so open and honest. At least that's what I get when I watch their videos. They're open, they're honest. They seem like the type of people that would bring me out of my shyness. So I guess I would want to meet them. Coco Femme, Kyo Kimmis, Jessica Loc, Jalicia, and Bronze Goddess. I probably would be awkward at first, but they seem like the type of people that talk a lot. I like to be around people that talk a lot because it makes me feel more comfortable and it allows me to let my guard down and I talk more because I'm a very quiet and shy person. So I guess I take that back, and I've already named the people I would want to hang out in real life. Well, I'm not going to tag anybody since this tag is so old. But if you want to do the tag, then go for it. So that is it for VEDA Day 29. Thank you so much for watching and for your support. One more day and I will have completed VEDA. And I'm so happy and proud of myself. And so I'll see y'all in the next video. Bye.